Hunger strike is the most peaceful means of struggle, particularly for prisoners. You know, Mahatma Gandhi in India also went on a number of hunger strikes, which had an effect on the British government. At times, he was released from prison, and other leaders of the Indian Congress were released because of the hunger strike. So we are here to say to the Palestinians that we are thinking of them. We wish to express our solidarity with them. And not only us in South Africa, all over the world, people are expressing their solidarity. And as a symbol of our solidarity, we decided not to eat for 24 hours.
This event, which organized by Ahmed Katrada Foundation, Embassy of Palestine, BDS, PSA, all solidarity movements who are in stand and support and in solidarity with the Palestinian people, we are in working in one hand, in one heart, in order to expose the Israeli practices against our prisoners, against our Palestinian people, and also we call the international community to pressurize Israel to implement the demands of Palestinian prisoners, which is a very legal and legal demands. It's a humanitarian demands. It's visitation for families, education, health, calls. It's basic things for our Palestinian prisoners.
There is the Israeli prison system complex is quite. It's quite complex. It includes also the involvement of multinational corporations that are profiting from the Israeli occupation. Companies like G4S Security Company that has been one of the major targets of the international BDS movement, the Boycott, Disinvestment and Sanctions movement, calling on multinational companies as well to divest from Israel. And to not find themselves complicit in the violations of Palestinian human rights.
We need South African Parliament to take action and real steps on the ground to communicate with all with the international parliaments, to communicate with the Pan-African Parliament, to communicate with the African Union, to raise the issue of Palestinian prisoners. Because without their support, without their pressure of the international community, without the pressure of Israel, we will never reach to our goal.
You know, Israel continues to act with utter impunity. And it's because partly because of the role of the international community. We are in part complicit because we don't do anything about it. You know, we could be doing more, you know, in terms of raising awareness on campuses, you know, advancing academic boycott campaigns, you know. In other countries, for example, you have municipalities at municipal level, you know, declaring their municipalities apartheid-free zones, where they ensure that no Israeli government-to-government, if you will, agreements or MOUs are signed.